This is the USS Louisiana. It's one of the Navy's current 14 nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines. This is China's version, the Type 094. It's one of the nation's 6 nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines. These submarines serve the same purpose. They're a sort of insurance policy in the event of a nuclear attack. But to do its job, each of these submarines has to do one thing really well: hide. We compare the Ohio-class submarines' technical capabilities and missiles with the Jin classes to see which comes out on top, and take a look at what each country has in store for the future of these nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines. On June 9, 1959, a decade into the Cold War, the United States launched this submarine, the USS George Washington. It was the Navy's first nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarine. These SSBNs are nuclear-powered, carry nuclear missiles, and are one arm of the U.S. military's nuclear triad, which includes intercontinental ballistic missiles, ballistic missile submarines, and bombers. And for the United States, SSBNs became a crucial part of its nuclear triad because of their survivability. That is, their ability to remain safe from anti-submarine warfare and, if needed, launch missiles past enemy defenses. In fact, SSBNs are the most survivable arm in the triad. So in the 1980s, the first Ohio-class nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarine entered service. The Ohio-class, still active today, was the Navy's 6th generation of SSBNs. 18 submarines in this class were built over the next 16 years, though 4 were later converted into cruise missile submarines. As these Ohio-class SSBNs were procured, China was building its first ballistic missile submarine, the Type 092, which became operational in 1983. They only fielded one, but it marked a turning point in China's nuclear capabilities. A few decades later in 2006, satellite imagery spotted the next generation, the Type 094. In its 2022 annual report, the Department of Defense says China has 6 operational Jin-class submarines running deterrence patrols. But these Type 094s are much noisier than the 1970s-era Soviet nuclear submarines.
And that would significantly undermine the overall survivability of the Chinese submarines, and therefore undermine the overall credibility of its sea-based nuclear deterrence.
Dr. Tang Zhao has been researching China's nuclear capabilities and strategic security issues for about a decade. The Ohio-class submarines are capable of carrying up to 24 missiles, but to comply with the New START treaty, only 20 are allowed to be carried. In contrast, the Jin-class submarines can only carry up to 12 missiles. And like each submarine's survivability, the missiles they carry are also critical factors in each military's strategy. The Navy's SSBNs have held a variety of missiles. Today, the Ohio-class submarines carry this missile, the Trident II. It's 44 feet long, has an 83-inch diameter, and weighs 130,000 pounds. That's about the weight of 5 school buses. Although the Trident II can carry up to 8 warheads, it likely carries only 3 or 4 to comply with the New START treaty. But most importantly, it has a range of about 4,000 nautical miles. And since 2017, the Navy has been updating these missiles to extend their life and increase their range even more, to about 6,480 nautical miles. The Department of Defense says that China's Jin-class submarines carry either the JL-2 or its next iteration, the JL-3. The JL-2 has 1 warhead, while the JL-3 has multiple. The JL-2's range is estimated to be about 3,780 nautical miles, and the JL-3's range reaches at least 5,400 nautical miles. This means that from China's shores, the JL-2 has sufficient range to target Guam or Alaska, but the JL-3 might target the continental U.S. from areas near China's coast. But
even if you put a longer range missiles on the Jin-class submarines, it's still the Jin-class submarine. They're still as noisy as the old ones.
Hans Christensen has studied the status of American nuclear weapons since the 1980s. And since noisiness impacts an SSBN's survivability, It makes it harder for China's submarines to travel further from the shores without being detected.
Even if you get longer range, that range is not sufficient to cover all of the continental United States unless you sail far into the Pacific.
And that's also difficult for China's submarines to do because of U.S. anti-submarine defenses across the Pacific Ocean.
Sea-based nuclear capabilities is one area in which China still lags behind the United States in a very significant manner. China understands that eventually nuclear submarine may be the most survivable part of a country's nuclear arsenal. So China had this long-term ambition to eventually acquire very advanced nuclear submarine technologies.
So what's China working on to close the gap? China is expected to begin construction on its next generation of SSBN, the Type 096, in the first part of this decade. These submarines will run with the existing Jin-class ones, and experts like Dr. Zhao say that the Type 096 will be quieter than its predecessor. But the U.S. is forging ahead, too. Construction on the next generation of SSBNs is already underway. These Columbia-class boomers will be even bigger than their predecessors.
This thing about the modernization cycle, you know, they don't happen at the same time in China and the United States. So there's sometimes a sort of a simplistic tendency or temptation in the debate for nuclear advocates to say, see, they're modernizing, we're not, therefore we're behind. But now we have actually, now we're entering our modernization cycle, and that will run for the next 2 to 3 decades.
The Ohio-class submarines are reaching the end of their lifetime. In just a few years, the first of its generation, the USS Ohio, will retire. By 2040, they are set to be replaced by Columbia-class SSBNs. The Navy is acquiring 12 new SSBNs, and each one will have room for 16 missiles, 8 less than the Ohio-class could carry. Cutting back might seem counterintuitive, but the US military estimates no more are needed to meet nuclear deterrence requirements. And the U.S. Navy says the Columbia-class submarines will be even quieter. That's because they're being built with an electric drive propulsion train versus the traditional mechanical drive system. So even if China's Type 096 is considerably quieter than its predecessor, it could be far less stealthy than the U.S.'s upcoming Columbia-class.
So we may see some incremental improvements, but doesn't mean that China will be at the same technical level with its American counterpart.